Welcome students, we are seeing basic accounting terminologies. We have covered so far transaction, cash transaction, credit transaction, what is account, what is a capital and what do you mean by drawings, voucher, invoice, sales, sales return, purchase, purchase return, goods and finally stock. Up to this we have covered. I will take further basic accounting terminologies now. Please stay connected. Students, now we are going to see what is income. What is income? Income is nothing but when goods sold, we are supposed to get some amount. We call it as receivable. Suppose you received it, either receivable or received from the sale of goods or earnings from interest, dividend, commission, all we call it as income. Income கிறது என்ன அப்படின்னா ஒரு goods நம்ம விற்கிறோம் அதுலேருந்து வரக்கூடிய realization, அது receivable-ஆ இருக்கலாம். Receivable-னா you may get the money later or you will get the money immediately. இந்த மாதிரி ரெண்டு ஆப்ஷன்லையும் இருக்கலாம், அதுவும் இன்கம் தான். இல்லைன்னா we are earnings interest, dividend, commission for any transaction also we call it as income. Okay, then what is expense? Expense is nothing but amount incurred to produce the goods. Okay, what is the amount incurred to produce the goods is also called, or goods or service is called as expense. Your goods நம்ம தயாரிக்கிறதுக்கான எல்லா செலவுகளையும் we call it as expense. So it's opposite of income. What is next term? Solvency. What is solvency? The company or the enterprise's ability to pay back the debts. ஒரு கம்பெனி வந்து கடன் வாங்கியிருக்கோம், அந்த கடனை திருப்பி செலுத்தக்கூடிய கெப்பாசிட்டி இருக்கா, that we call it as solvency. What is insolvency? கம்பெனியால கடனை திருப்பி கட்ட முடியாத சிச்சுவேஷன், we call it as insolvency. It nothing but incapability of a person or enterprise to pay back the debt. Or clear? Then what is next one you call? Asset. Asset அப்படின்னா என்ன? Any physical things or right that has a mandatory value we call it as asset. For example, you take this AC is an asset, vehicle is an asset, building is an asset. So these are we call it as asset. Next one is liability. What is liability? It's a financial obligation of the business. What is a financial obligation? இப்ப ஒரு asset வாங்குறோம், AC வாங்குறோம் 35,000 ரூபாய்க்கு, and you are going to pay after say 2-3 months, we call it as liability. So AC வாங்குறோம் 35,000 rupees, that I will pay only after a month, so we create as a liability 35,000. So it's a financial obligation to pay, it's called as a liability. Then next term is called debtor. What is debtor? A person who receives the benefit, a person who receives the benefit, okay, who receives the benefit, okay, clear up to this? A person who receives the benefit without giving money or money's worth immediately. So he will take the AC here in this example, but he is not paying the AC of 35,000 rupees immediately, then we call this person as a debtor. Clear? A person who receives the benefit is not paying the money immediately, but he will pay later. Correct? He is a debtor. And a person, what is another term we call as creditor? Creditor na enna? What is creditor? A person who gives benefit. Okay, and who receives benefit, who gives benefit without receiving the money immediately. without receiving the money immediately. Is called it as a creditor. Okay, in the given example, AC, you are buying AC.
Okay,
is a dealer. I am buying AC. Okay, we call it as D. So from dealer X, we bought an AC for 35,000. We bought it at the rate of 35,000. Here, B has agreed to pay to the dealer X after a month. So here, in the books of dealer, B account as a debtor. Okay, because he will pay after a month. He is a debtor. In the books of B, dealer has become creditor. Clear, student? Any doubt, debtor, creditor? Students, let me explain debtor, creditors in a very simple way. Let us take an example of ABC. This is a company. Okay? There is another company. We call it as XYZ. Okay? So, there are two companies. Company 1 is ABC. Company 2 is called XYZ. Okay. ABC company selling goods. Any goods in which you will have? Any goods according to your choice? Any goods? So, company ABC is selling. Simple line in which you will have? Grocery in which you will have? Easier. Okay. So ABC is selling grocery worth 10,000 rupees to XYZ. Okay? So for XYZ, it's a purchase. Okay? So ABC is selling grocery worth 10,000 rupees to XYZ. So in the books of XYZ, it's a purchase of grocery. How much? 10,000 rupees. Clear? So AB is selling grocery 10,000 to XYZ, purchase of grocery 10,000. So in the books of ABC, the grocery he will write as a sales. Grocery what he will write? Sales. In the books of XYZ, grocery what he will write as purchase. So here we call it as purchase, here we call it as sales. Clear, students? Then next step, in the 10,000 rupees, XYZ either can pay immediately, it means a cash transaction, or he will pay after a month, then we call it as a credit transaction. There are two ways of doing, so let us complicate little further. In the same 10,000 rupees, XYZ is willing to pay immediately, means cash 5,000 rupees. Balance 5,000 rupees, he says I will pay after a month. Clear? So this 5,000 rupees we call it as a cash transaction, this 5,000 rupees we call it as a credit transaction. So when he is paying cash immediately, what he will do? He will also receive cash. Receive cash 5,000, balance 5,000 due from where? X, Y, Z. Here what we will say after a month? Due to whom? A, B, C. Limit. Clear? So in the 10,000 rupees, if you pay cash immediately 5,000, we call it as a cash transaction. If he pays after a month, we call it as a credit transaction. Then in the books of XYZ, he will write due to ABC 5,000 rupees. Okay? He is liable to pay. He is liable to pay. In the books of ABC, he received cash 5,000. Balance is due from XYZ. So when he said due from, it's a debtor. In the books of ABC, we call it as XY is a company as a debtor. How much? 5000. In the books of XYZ, this 5000 we call it as creditor. Creditor, who is creditor? ABC is our creditor, because there is a liability to pay 5000 to ABC. So in the books of XYZ, we call it as creditor. In the books of XYZ. In the books of ABC, XYZ will be treated as a debtor. So this is due from XYZ is a debtor. Due to ABC, in the books of XYZ, ABC will become a creditor. Clear, students? This is called debtors and creditors. Next one we call it as depreciation. What is depreciation? Nothing but wear and tear. See, we are using, let us take an example of two-wheeler. We are using a two-wheeler frequently, and there is a wear and tear, we call it as a depreciation. And the depreciation will actually reduce the value of the assets. Because when you go even for insurance to two-wheeler, they will take depreciated value. We bought the two-wheeler for 70,000 rupees, and after a year they will say we will value at a depreciable rate, and that after depreciation the value is only at 62,000. It is called depreciation, nothing but wear and tear over a period of lifetime. Then bad debts. What is bad debts? Suppose this customer XYZ is supposed to pay 5000 back to ABC and he closed down the business. Let us assume XYZ closed the business. He said, sir, sorry sir, I am closing, I cannot pay you anymore, I closed down the operation. Then it is a bad debts for ABC. இது பேர் தமிழ்ல வார கடன். This 5000 rupees he cannot collect from XYZ because XYZ has closed down the business. In the books of ABC it's a bad debt, vara kadan, because there is a 5000 due from him which he couldn't collect, it become bad debt. Clear, students? So far good. Students, now we are going to cover branches of accounting. What are the branches in accounting? என்னென்ன branches இருக்குன்னு பார்க்க போறோம். Accounting அப்படிங்கிறது general. Okay? Accounting அப்படின்னா general. So accounting first in financial accounting. Financial accounting. This is one branch. Accounting one branch called financial accounting. நெக்ஸ்ட் நம்ம பார்க்க போறது என்ன? காஸ்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். காஸ்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங் இஸ் another branch. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் கால் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங் இஸ் another branch. மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். தென் சோசியல் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி அக்கவுண்டிங், nothing but CSR, corporate social responsibility accounting, we call it as CSR. This is another branch. Okay, then human resources accounting. Okay, students, there are important five. Okay, accounting is a general. So when you take accounting, first we call it as financial accounting, cost accounting, management accounting, CSR accounting, human resources accounting. What is financial accounting? All the transaction which involves financial transaction or a business or enterprise, we call it as a financial accounting. What are the terminologies we saw in financial accounting is also I explained in detail. So next is cost accounting. What is cost accounting? To manufacture any goods or article, we need to really identify what is the cost of manufacturing. What is the cost? Raw material evolve, working capital evolve, labor evolve, material cost evolve, material mixing cost evolve. In the mari nariya data analyze pandrathu cost accounting to arrive at the price of the product. Then only we can fix the selling price. So cost accounting is nothing but to arrive at the manufacturing cost. okay, manufacturing cost or expenses directly incurred to produce the article or product. That is called as a cost accounting. So financial accounting அப்படினா என்னன்னு தெரியும், காஸ்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங்னா என்ன தெரியும், வாட் இஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். சி இந்த ரெண்டு டீடைலும் இது வந்து ஒரு ப்ராடக்டோட இண்டிவிஜுவல் காஸ்டிங் பத்தி சொல்றது, ஃபினான்ஷியல்ங்கிறது ஓவரால் கம்பெனியோட ப்ராஃபிட்டபிலிட்டி, ஆபரேட்டிங் ப்ராஃபிட், பேலன்ஸ் ஷீட்டு, நெட்வொர்க் இதை பத்தி சொல்றது. இது ரெண்டையும் லிங்க் பண்ணி மேனேஜ்மெண்ட்டுக்கு டிசிஷன் டேக்கிங் எடுக்கிறதுக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்றது தான் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். ஸோ மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங்கோட மெயின் அஜெண்டா என்னன்னா, இட் ஹெல்ப் டு அனலைஸ் தி காஸ்ட் இன்வால்வ் இன் ப்ரொடியூசிங் தி ப்ராடக்ட் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ சி வெதர் ப்ராஃபிட்டபிளி வி கேன் ரன் த ஆபரேஷன் ஆர் நாட். டு டேக் அ மேனேஜரியல் டிசிஷன் திஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங் இஸ் ஹெல்பிங். திஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங் இஸ் ப்ரிப்பேர்ட் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த பிரைமரி டேட்டா ஃப்ரம் ஃபினான்ஷியல் அண்ட் காஸ்ட் அக்கவுண்டிங். வாட் இஸ் சிஎஸ்ஆர்? சோசியல் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி அக்கவுண்டிங். கார்பரேட் சோசியல் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி அப்படின்னா என்னன்னா, வி ஆர் யூசிங் என்விரான்மெண்டல், வி ஆர் யூசிங் இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர், ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த பொல்யூஷன், pollution control steps we have taken, okay, what are the water resources we use, this kind of a social responsibility the corporate is supposed to maintain because we are using all the natural environments in the vicinity. So what is the social cost involved in associated for carrying out the business or operation also to be checked. So what are the social responsibilities? I am using water, I am using infrastructure, I am using resources, okay, I am using the environmental, whether it is affecting the pollution, all these kind of costing we have to arrive because corporates also have a corporate social responsibility to the society back. This we talk about social accounting. What is human resources accounting? We are employing manpower, so we have to identify how many manpower we employed, what is the cost of an employee for the company, what is the investment pattern for the human resources accounting, what are the benefits available to the human by employing this staff in this company. Okay, it is nothing but is concerned with the identification, qualification, reporting of investment made in human resources. Because இப்போ ஒரு கம்பெனிக்கு ஒருத்தர் ஹையர் பண்ணா இமீடியட்டா அவரால் ஜாப்ல கூட உட்கார முடியாது. We have to train them. That is a cost of training. So we have to spend money for this development. So after developing that particular gentleman, whether the human resources has put into use effectively, that also form part of the cost accounting. Now there is a cost involved. Clear student? These are the branches in accounting. So major financial, cost accounting, management accounting, CSR accounting and human resources accounting. Clear student? For your knowledge students, just think, do you think financial accounting, cost accounting and management accounting can be maintained by the same person? All these things can be maintained by the same person? Just think of for your knowledge, and in tomorrow session I will take basis of accounting. Thank you and welcome to all. Best wishes.